An alternate way of running a lot of samples is to use a fiber optic probe. It can be remotely triggered while you're running the sample, but the most important thing is that you have a defined path length. And of course, that's important for quantitative analysis. And depending on the samples that you have, different tips can be added to be compatible with whatever solvent system you're using. So now we're going to construct a calibration curve to show how easy it is. So I place the probe inside the vessel. I have to make sure that I cover the full path length, which I do. Now all I have to do is just click the trigger and the measurement is made. Now we come back and we run the second low standard. And again, press the button and take a measurement. So now we'll measure our middle standard. Again, we'll put the probe into the solution, press the trigger, and now the measurement's made. And now our final high concentration standard. So in a very short period of time, we were able to construct a calibration curve, and now I can measure all of my unknowns. And as you can see, a very large number of samples can be measured in a very short period of time. Now most people say you can measure powders, a solid sample, on a UV-Vis spectrophotometer. Well, you need a special accessory, and that's called a remote DRA, or diffuse reflectance accessory. And what we're going to demonstrate today is we have some color tiles. We're going to measure those, and then we're going to compare them to the standard to show you that we can, in fact, actually measure the color of the system. And one other nice thing about this system is it also includes a video camera. So you can take a picture of what you're analyzing, and then you have the spectrum to identify what it is, and you have the complete answer. This is the diffuse reflectance accessory. It hooks up to the optical system of the Cary 60. This is the alignment bracket, which we set the detector on. So we place this over the sample. The hole indicates where we are on the sample. And once we've done that, we simply put the diffuse reflectance accessory onto the bottom bracket. This is the detector, and this is the camera that will take a picture of it. So we're going to do this on three color slides, and we're going to see our results. So first we place the base plate on the sample, we verify that we're on top of the sample, and then we place the diffuse reflectance accessory on top of the base plate. Now we can take a measurement of the spectra of that particular tile, or we can take a picture. The picture verifies where we are on the tile, so we can say that this is the color coming from that particular sample. So when would people use diffuse reflectance of a solid or of a powder? Well, for product uniformity, sometimes for counterfeiting, see if the colors are from one manufacturer to another or from the counterfeiter to the manufacturer, or in art conservation studies where they're trying to make sure that this is in fact an old painting, because you can determine that by the pigments that have been used in the paint to see whether it's a new paint, old paint, or whatever.